Hey, hey. Saturday, and we're ready. Happy Saturday, ladies. Just on real quick, trying out some new things that we're excited about. So we came on a little bit earlier. Gonna see. Hope all of our new gadgets and gadgets are working nice. We'll find out in just a minute. So we're on. Hey, Miss Connie. How are you? All right, we're testing out some new equipment, so we're going to need to know, you know, make sure sound is good and you're able to see everything. We got to get some new things going on, trying to expand our reach. So just put me maybe, Connie, if you could put some thumbs up, that would be amazing. Let me know. So either give some hearts or some thumbs up if you ladies can hear me. Let me know what's going on. Video and audio are great. Okay, good. Thank you, Connie. Thank you so much. Like I said, we have our new toys going on. We're excited. We're going to see how it all works out today. All right, I see your thumbs up, Miss Marcia. Thank you. And I'm actually going to try a little something. I'm going to try to get a little fancy since we've rewrapped up our Sheroes of the Faith. And I think it went well. Wow. Try to get us a little music going on. It's Saturday. To get us all in a good Saturday mood. I hope you've had a good week. Mine was a little busy, but busy kind of long. I'm actually looking forward to hanging out with you ladies right now, though. This is called Come a Fight Song. I don't know about anybody else, but every now and then I get in that mode where feel like I'm just in the middle of a battle. But one of the things I like is, ladies, that we need to remember that I hold on to, that I'm not fighting to get the victory. We're fighting from victory. So that encourages me. Yep. Hope you guys feel the same way. We'll hold on just a little bit. Good, good, good deal, good deal, good deal. Just excited about the fact that everything looks good, it's getting clearer, getting better. I like that. So we're going to be talking today. We're going to be talking about community. We're going to be talking about a couple of opportunities and things that are going on at the church. And I just really want to hopefully get to the point where we can open this up and we're chatting about some things that's going on in you guys, in your lives, and how as not just as a church, but as a community of women that meet here, I want to make sure that we're meeting your needs and we're serving up resources that are going to help you walk a little bit closer to the Lord in this season. So that's my prayer, right? That's what I'm hoping for as we walk and work together, okay? All right, who's cooking this afternoon? Are you cooking, Miss Connie? Let me know. Send. Let us know. Are you cooking? Will you be relaxing? I know I normally pick a day. One of the weekend days, I choose to not cook just because I don't want to. So I won't do it because I don't have to and I don't always feel like it. We had Winn-Dixie. Oh, that's nice. Their hot food section is good, though. I'm going to put that out there. Come on, Miss Connie. Their hot food section is really, really good. I like their different flavored wings. Mm-hmm. Yep, so I understand. Yep, I will be joining you in that. I will not be cooking this afternoon. Yep, I've said that to myself because I don't feel like it. Yes, that's right. All the things. All the things going on in here. Yes. Absolutely, me too. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because it's kind of when on those long weeks, I just don't feel like it. And as my boys are getting older, I've resolved myself to, I don't have to. We can all sit down and I'm looking forward to the day where they'll go, Mom, how about we do a dinner and we cook for you? I'm going to be waiting for that one, you guys. Mm-hmm. Well, I'm going to give it one more minute and then yeah, weekends are for the boys to cook. Yes. Amen. Hey, Miss Orr, glad you popped on, friend. Good to see you as usual. As always, good to have you joining us on the live. We're going to be talking community and just things that are going on in the church and the ministry and what we're going to be doing. Okay. So it's 6:05. We're going to get in it and we're going to end with a little praise, because on long weeks and long days, I don't know about anybody else, nothing seems to change my perspective better than when I can get into a good spot of some praise and worship. Hello, Your Honor. Oh, you're on a sister trip. Well, enjoy, Miss O. I'm glad you popped in. Hi. I'm glad you popped in to join us. Well, it is 6:05, ladies, and I'm going to go ahead and get on and just talk about a couple of things that we want to cover here. And I know I was thinking the past couple of days, like something that I wanted to cover. One of the things I wanted to talk about was community and how important it is that we have community. Everything that we do here, whether it's in the church, whether we do it on our Facebook page, our women's Facebook page here, anything that we're doing as a ministry, it's always to foster community, because it's so important that as women, as humans, that we stay connected, especially in this time right here. Life can get tough. Matter of fact, it can get hard. But when you have other people that you can connect to, that you can get with and grow through those tough times and grow through those tough seasons, it makes it a little bit different. It really does. So that's something I wanted to talk about. And I wanted to ask you guys, what is community? You guys can throw some questions, some answers there in the chat. What is community? What do you feel community is to you? And I'm going to give it a chance. Like I said, go ahead, throw some answers up in there. What do you think community is? Because I know it's kind of a word we've talked about. it's kind of been popped out around the Christian circle. And I wanna know kind of what do you see community as? You can pop a couple of answers in there, because I think it's so important that we know what things are so that we can get an understanding of why we want to be involved with them. You know, it really helps to do that. Yep. So we're talking all things community. What is community? What does that mean? Or what does that look like to you? And I know it'll help us kind of understand where we're going and what we're doing as I try to get my life. Community is the group of people that you do life with. Yes. Good, Miss Marcia. Yes. Yep. Good answer. I've always wanted to say that. Good answer. I like that. Participating in activities that help us come closer together in our hearts. Oh, that's good. That's good. That's real good. I know. I see you, Miss Marsha. I see you doing your thing. And we're going to talk about all of that. That's why I'm entering with community, Miss Marsha. I'm going to explain it all. I see you doing your thing. And girls, I'll explain later why we're so excited. Community, a group of people living in the same place or having a particular characteristic in common. This is my favorite right here. Like I am doing today with my sisters. That's right. A feeling of fellowship with others as a result of sharing common attitudes, interests, and goals. I'm gonna say that again. A feeling of fellowship with others as a result of sharing common attitudes, interests, or goals. Community. And girls, I really wanted to talk about that today. The importance of of having community, and not just having it, making sure you're in community. And when you're in it, the people that you're going to have in your community. And what I did was I took a look at the fact that Jesus is our example of what community looked like. If you think about it, Jesus spent his time with people when he was here on this earth. He spent time with groups. He spent time with the masses, then he spent time with the 12, then he spent time with the 3. And you also, yes, you will see an example, and you will see repeated examples where it said that Jesus went alone to pray. But we also see that he spent time in community. He spent time with people that needed him to pour into them. And then he spent time with his smaller core, with the inside group, the ones that he connected with. And I thought, what a great example that we have in our Heavenly Father, in Jesus, that he left us here to show us the example and the importance of community. Now, one of the other things I got was, to go so far as that it's talked about in the scriptures, it says that we are to encourage each other as long as the day is the day. So the Bible even talks about us encouraging one another, about having fellowship. We look in the back book of Acts. I'm reading through the book of Acts right now, and it talked about how they met together. They had the breaking of bread, and they had fellowship. And the reason why this is so important, girls, we were not created to do life alone. We just wasn't. That's not how God made us. Listen, Eve always had somebody. Think about it. Eve was never alone. Adam was created. The animals, the birds, the grass, the this. But Eve was created and Adam was always there. So I'm not trying to prove that point to say, yeah, you always need a man. No. But what I am saying is that as human beings, we were created for community. We were created to connect. We were created to be encouragement and to get encouragement from one another. So I want to talk about the fact of, you know, ask yourself, am I in community? And then, you know, do a little searching and then ask yourself, why am I not in community? You need to be able to ask that, ladies, because it's so important. And the reason why I'm going to talk about the importance of it is if you're not in community, you're spiritually going to dry up. your passions are going to dry up. Your fire is going to die. Take a coal when you're doing a barbecue. As long as all those coals are together, the fire is going. It's booming. It's hot. It's good. But you take that one coal and you sit it off to the side by itself, that coal's fire will burn out. That's why God created us to be in community with one another. So I want to encourage you, get in fellowship, get in community. And that's going to lead me into what I'm getting ready to talk about right now. We have created resources. As a church, we've created resources. You can go in through our app and you can go to Right Now Media. You can get Bible studies that you can share. You can invite and share somebody, like Miss Orr was talking about, she's with a group of friends. She can invite a couple of those friends to be a part of our Right Now Media and they can study the word together. They can get in and go deeper. You can take the messages that you get from Pastor on Sunday. Take those sermon notes, the action items that he's giving you, the key takeaways. Study it with somebody. Guys, we have our phones. You can FaceTime. Don't do life alone. Find someone that's on the journey with where you are. Get connected. Get plugged in. We were not created to do life alone. And to show you as a church how we're trying to create better avenues for that is right now, I got excited because you saw Miss Marsha just responded from YouTube. So right now, we're literally able to show our broadcast from Facebook where we are right now, YouTube, Instagram, however the Lord leads us to do that, because as a church, we're wanting to make sure that people can be in community, that they can stay connected. So, like I said, I was going to talk about the importance of you being in community, how you can do it. Guys, there's also something else in our app. Thank you, Ms. Marsha, popping in those resources. There is a link, and I believe Ms. Marsha can pop this to it, where we literally giving you 14 different lessons. And I'm going to hop in and I'm going to show it to you on my phone because I'm going to go in through the app because I love the fact that we have a leadership. I love it that God took this, placed it in my husband's heart. That's not just excited about you getting hooked to just what he wants, he has to say, which is important and which is what God sends down through him, but also wanting you to know how to get connected and grow on your own. So you go in through the app, you go and you click grow, which is at the bottom where that heart is. I got to find my camera, girls. I'm going to find it. See, you hit that where the grow is, you hit the grow. You can go to the growth track. You click the growth track. And look here, it's called worksheets to download. Girls, you got worksheets where you can go in. You can get with friends. You can download a lesson. And when you do, say you want to talk to someone about salvation. They want to know what it's like about getting saved. There it is. Look. Because we're concerned about you guys growing. That's what I wanted to take a minute to share with you. You can get these resources, get with a friend, get connected, and grow. I was riding by and going to church last Sunday, and I saw the store, Rooms to Go. And the Lord just hit me. It was like, what if we looked at this season's not about rooms to go, but are we making room to grow? Are you making room for community? Are you creating space to grow you and help you be bigger on the inside than you are on the outside? And you don't have to do that by yourself. As a church, we've created that. Even on this women's Facebook page, you can go to files, click files, and you will see all the sheroes of the faith where you can take those resources, sit down with a friend, once again, coworker, family member, plug it in and go through the scriptures. We've given you resources. We want you to be connected in community and begin to grow. So starting the first of the year, ladies, we're going to be creating our groups that are going to be launching in 2021. We're going to be talking about that some more. But I want to talk about what we're going to be doing on our women's Facebook page. So every other week, we're going to have coffee and conversations. And you guys know I'm always going to ask you this. When we finish this live, Marsha and I are going to work on a graphic. We're going to post it. And we want to know. Yeah, that's a message. Room to grow. Yes, it is. The Lord just laid that in my heart. Are we creating space for that? We're going to post and we want to have a survey. We're going to ask, what are some topics you want to hear about? Ladies, post it in underneath that post. Give us your reply. And if you don't feel comfortable doing it that way, send something in anonymously. You can do it through an email. You can text me. We'll find a way for you to let us know, what are some topics you want to hear about in this season? We're asking because we want to know. I'll be creating conversations with my sisters, bringing in people to talk about things. Right now, a couple of our topics are going to be faith and fitness. We're going to be talking about mental health in a very stressful time. We're going to be talking about how to walk out your purpose, whether that be launching a business, starting a study, learning how to handle healthy relationships. We're going to be creating those spaces and inviting speakers in. But before we even get into all of that, we want to know, what are some topics that you want to hear about so that you can make room to grow? Okay. So we're almost at the end, ladies. I told you I wasn't going to be here long. Just wanted to touch on a couple of things about community. Listen, ladies, remember this. When you find community, you find commonality. When you find commonality, it's there that you discover your purpose and you discover that, you know what? I was created to do something alone. I wasn't created to do life alone, but I was created to do something amazing and help somebody else. So that's something that we're going to be talking about. We're going to be launching, but we also want to hear from you. What are some things you ladies want to hear about? Okay. So we put the links in here. Miss Marsha has given you resources. You can click those at any point in time. You can grow. You can click the file section on this page where you can grow, because we want you in community. And I listen, when I see some of you girls, I'm going to be asking, are you in community with someone? Are you doing life with another sister? It's called life on life. You don't have to do this by yourself, because we can't. I tell the girls that I mentor quite often that I've been living a long time. And even in my lifetime of living, I have mentors. I have women that I get with and we talk, because there are days when I'm struggling. There are days when I don't always get it right. And when that happens, I need to be able to call my girl and go, listen, I'm on this ledge. I need you to come get me. You got to come get me off this edge, because somebody about to get it. Because it's so important that we're doing that. Oh, thank you so much, Connie. I love your tenderness for the scriptures, my friend. Definitely good sister to connect with. A lot of understanding here and compassion Miss Connie has. She's a good. Tender, encouraging sister. And that's what we need to be doing. Get to know your sisters a little bit better. Get to know your friends. Get to know the girls in here. Listen, we're going to be creating this as a, we call our women's group is called C Girls. Every now and then we're going to circle up. I want you to circle up and build circles with your other sisters. Build circles with the other women that are in this group. We're going to be connecting and not just, oh yeah, well, I came here on Saturday. Nope, we're going to be putting things on here during the week. We want you guys making space for you to have room to grow, okay? So before we pop out, I'm going to turn on a little bit of music, because y'all know I like to get my praise on. It's not going to be long. And I'm going to be asking that. I'm going to be asking you girls to post your playlist. Listen, go on Spotify. Build you a playlist. Get you some good music. Get fit. Get moving. This is the season. Start working. Start walking. Getting those healthy things going inside of your body. Because how you feel and what you're feeding yourself on the inside, it's going to reflect on the outside. Okay, so we're going to be talking about all of that. All right, and I want you girls, I want us all connecting. This is my fight song. Okay? Got a battle cry. And girls, something that I did at the beginning of this year, the beginning of each year, I asked the Lord to give me a word. Listen, and he's been faithful to do that. The beginning of this year, he gave me the word fight. I couldn't understand it. I didn't like it. And I did ask for another one, because you know, fight, what that mean? I mean, you get fight, that means you're going to have battles. I understand. There are times he's asked me, I've had to fight for me. I've had to fight for my mental capacity. I've had to fight to hold on to things that I know God has said to me that didn't look like it was coming through, but I had to fight to stand on his word. And then the one that God really pressed on me, girls, I had to fight for the next sister that couldn't fight for herself. Come on. You might have your fight down. You might be good at this. But every now and then, God calls us to fight. And sometimes you need community to be able to do that a little bit better. You look at a good fighter, he's got a great, great corner. Who's in your corner? We know that Jesus is. We want you to know your girls in here. We're in your corner. We're cheering you on. We're fighting for you because you can do it. Okay? Fight for community. Sometimes you might have to fight through. You got to fight for your family. Yep, you have to do that sometimes. You have to fight to stand on God's word. And then sometimes, I'm going to leave you with this. Sometimes you got to fight to be still. I just thought I'd drop that one. You have to fight to be still and know that God is God and let him do it. All right? So, girls, we've given you some resources. We've let you know that what we're going to be offering here in the Sea Girls Ministry, what we're going to be offering, fight for her. Yep. Ah, who just said that? That's good. We're going to be letting you know what resources we have coming. I love God because he just spoke. He's so good. What we're going to be offering here, but we also want to know what is it that you ladies want to hear about? What are some things that are tugging on your heart that you need a little more encouragement on? Okay? So, community, connecting, all right? And then we want to know what are some things you ladies want to hear about, okay? Yep, I see what you put in there. I see that. So, ladies, listen, enjoy the rest of your Saturday. If you have any questions, there's anything you want to say to me right now, we'll give it about another 2 or 3 minutes before we get off here. But in the meantime, girls, I'm always going to say this. Please know how loved you are by God. He sees you. He hears you. You're his number one girl. And I know everybody sees that. I find myself fighting for overwhelmed coworkers. Come on. Amen. And we can do our best battling in prayer, can't we? That's right. We can do our best battling in prayer. Amen. Yeah. We have to fight for others because we might have it down. But every now and then we have to fight for others. Amen. So good. So good. So good. Thank you for sharing that. Amen. So girls, gonna wrap it up. Stay encouraged. Keep your chin up. Your knees down. And remember, you're loved, you're valued. Get in community. Get connected so that you can continue to grow. That's right. The fight begins on our knees. All right?